Hello and welcome. Today I would like to demonstrate to you how to create a toposurface from imported CAD file, let's say survey points that are already developed in AutoCAD. You know that in Masonon site here you could create your own topo by specifying, you have to be in the site, I forget that. So you need to be in the site. Not at the first second level because it's related to site, and you could start placing points. You could see here, and then you change the height here if it's millimeters, whatever, and then you place, you know, if your site going up or down, then you could just keep doing that until you finish your site, and then once you click OK, you have a toposurface. Let me change the visibility to, and this is your it's not showing 3D, and this is our tool. Change this to shaded, and if I turn the what is my section box, okay, and then you could so see that there is like I'm just grabbing these points, and you could see that it's a height and everything, but that's not what I want to do today. I want to do this through a proper file that was or proper survey points that was created in AutoCAD. So if I just show you what I have here, I have an AutoCAD file which I imported or downloaded from the internet. Looks like it's, these are the AutoCAD. The first thing we need to do before you start importing, make sure that these, sometimes you get a file that has no elevation, no heights in. So I need to make sure that these lines have elevation to it, not only 2D lines, but also has a 3D information to it. So if I click one line, bear with me, this is a bit heavy file. If I look here, it says elevation. So this has an elevation, yeah? Another line. This is very important. If it doesn't have the elevation, it doesn't work out of it. So you have to have this information in the property that gives you the inside the x and y vertex to tell you that has elevation. This is very important. So once we get that, I'm gonna go to Revit now, and in Revit I'm gonna import this. So from the manage site, I'll go to toposurface. Instead of creating like I showed you before, I'm gonna say not placing point, I'm gonna say import, so cancel. Before that, let me close this. The file is not here yet, so I need to bring the AutoCAD file here by linking it to this file, to Revit. So I'm gonna go to insert, link CAD, and then I look at my CAD already in my, it's here. This is my file, and I'll say center to center. I agree with this, it's okay. Also, it should not, okay, it doesn't say side, but I'm in the side level, so it's okay. Preserve, I could keep the colors. I want this to show even in the 3D, not only this level, so this is okay. And I'm just gonna say open. So now the file will come here. It's a bit heavy file, and I will work with that. Yeah. So this is my file. First of all, I could query this. Okay, this is because it's an imported instance. I could select this and I query whatever lines, for example. So this is contour index, I may need this. Maybe this point here is a spot elevation. I don't need this because any points here will create a toposurface, so the computer will convert it to a topo. So the spot elevation is not needed really here, so I could hide it or delete it, but maybe I'm just gonna hide it. I don't want to see it. But also, if I go to the VG visibility graphic, could go to the imported categories, and I look here, these are the levels that are already imported here. So maybe I don't want to see the zero, because if I hit apply, doesn't, yeah, so that labels, for example, is, I don't need labels, I only need controls, spot elevations already moved. So this is what I could see now. So let me convert this from the topo, from the manage site. I'm gonna go to topo service, and then I say from import instance. And this is my file, and there, again, that one was just visibility. Now, if I created the topo, it's gonna take all these levels. So 0, I didn't have anything on the 0, the index, the spot elevation, I don't want that to convert to a topo. Also the label here, also need this. So I only need the contour intermediate, the contour index, with the, which is the brown line you see here. I say okay. Now this should be converted in a few seconds. Take a few seconds to convert. Yeah, it's a bit heavy. You'll see when once converted, you see how many points this this site has. It's a whole site, not a, so I believe it's a whole city, which I downloaded from the internet. And it's taking a bit while here because of the, so now you see this, all these dark represent survey points. See how many survey points here? This is a huge file, but just for demonstration purpose, if I hit, I approve this now, this will be converted to a, as you could see here. And just to show you, I'm gonna go to manage, and I will is it manage, and then manage links. I just gonna unload this file, the CAD file. Now this is the Revit file, yeah. And if I use the section box like I showed you before, and I could show you the height of these, you know. So now you could see that there is thickness, and the height is showing here through this. If I could do this around, so now this is my cells. If I'm not happy with the weight looks of, I need to reduce the size, make it look like real, I could go to the VG again, VG, and now this time looking at the topography, and maybe I remove these lines so only the topo itself shows, and now this looks like something as very close to reality. And this is what, how you could import survey data from AutoCAD to Revit. Yeah?